Our next guest is a fascinating performer, or as we say in Indiana, preformer. She came to this country as a singer in the 1950s and developed a tremendous, developed a tremendous cult following. She has a 5-octave vocal range, and she has been called a miracle of nature, her voice has. And to top it off, this woman is an Inca princess. She is currently working here in New York at the Ballroom. Ladies and gentlemen, brace yourselves. Please welcome the Peruvian nightingale, Ima Sumac. That's a, boy, that's a very mystical sound you have there, isn't it? I mean, it's a swelling and undulating and drifting and peculiar, but enjoyable.
You like it?
Oh, yeah, I enjoyed
that.
I'm
so glad to hear that.
Now, tell me about this octave. Most people have a what octave range? Like, if I were singing, I'd probably have what, 3 octaves?
I don't know. I got to hear you first.
Well, there's not a chance in hell of that happening. But for most singers, what is a normal range?
Some of them, they have 2 or 3 octaves.
Mm-hmm. And yet you have 5.
I have 5 because the reason that I have 5 octaves, because I was born in the high Andes.
Mm-hmm.
And the high
Where the
Andes,
air is thin.
The air makes expand your lungs.
Could you demonstrate the high end and the low end of the octave range?
But I did.
You just did there.
Yes, I did.
Let me hear the lowest part again. Can you do that?
Yeah. I don't know if I can.
Okay,
I know
we'll give it a try.
At this time, it's very difficult to sing.
We have to. Well, that was good. Now let me hear the high.
No.
We have to what? We have to do a commercial answer. We'll be right back. Much for being here. You'll be at the Ballroom here in New York through Sunday.
Yes, yes.
Thank you.
I will
good luck to you.
Sunday.
Thank you so much. My thanks also to Jan Hooks and Sam Donaldson. Tomorrow, folks, Jerry Seinfeld and Bill Murray. Thank you very much. Come again. Have a good night.